Now, the breeze is picking up because of this low-pressure system way to the northwest of us, spilling in these weather fronts, and it's on the forward side of those we'll see the strongest of the winds. Southern and western parts of England and Wales through the night into the morning. Gusts at 70, maybe 80 miles an hour for one or two. Widespread gales for many. Heavy rain as well, so after initial frost in the east, temperatures lift, but we will see that heavy rain push its way eastwards. Very gusty winds with it. Finishes the night dry though in Northern Ireland, but a wet start for much of England, Wales and Scotland before that rain clears out into the afternoon. So by the afternoon, most...
Sounds like a good time to go camping, I think. Well, guys, I'm out in the woods. I'm looking for a safe place to camp. I plan on coming out later on this evening. The weather's going to be bad and I want to experience a storm. But there's no way I'm going to walk into this wood at dusk and try and find somewhere to camp, because you don't know what's above you. In fact, there's nowhere safe, I'd say, in this piece of woodland. The trees are all very mature. Some of them are leaning at alarming angles. A heavy wind could bring them down, and I might not go home in the morning. And I don't want that to happen. So this isn't a suitable environment, not for a storm. I'm gonna have to search elsewhere. When I found that ideal spot, I'm gonna make a cache of some heavy items, save me having to carry them in later. So let's see if I can find somewhere suitable. I get good feelings about this area. It looks inviting. It's fairly flat. There's no tall trees overhead to pose any threat. Yeah, I think this would be my campsite for later on. Fairly flat, dry. There are trees around, but they're all on the small side. And those bigger trees, they're all going to be downwind of me because the wind is going to come from the south-southwest. So, and they're all leaning slightly that way, so they're not going to fall down on top of me. There's a woodpecker. So you get an idea, it's all... They're all fairly small trees, probably 15, 20 foot high. That one just there is potentially the biggest risk. And you can see someone's made a lean-to shelter there in the past. Again, it's a solid tree. The problem with camping in the woods is that there's no guarantee of safety, especially in a high wind, because trees do come down. Unexpectedly sometimes, but I feel fairly confident this is a safe place to be in the woodland, drawing heavy winds. I don't advocate that you try it, mind, you do so at your own risk. Making a cache of water.
so I don't have to carry. We can come back here later on. Now I'm going to be coming back into this woodland at night time, so I'll make sure I can find my way in there. So I'll mark this position on the E-Trex. That's it. It's been marked OK. So I can navigate back using this later on. Well, here we are. We're in the woods. It says welcome. Oh. Oh, strictly no camping or fires. Alright. Let's go. Squeeze through that. Oh. Yeah, I don't know what you can see. Not a lot, I don't think. There's Elsa. And we're on our way in the woods to our campsite destination. Right, get back to you in a minute. I can buy myself some new boots. My old one sprung a leak. Anyway, they're getting well christened here. Pretty muddy going. Anyway, we're not far away from the campsite now. Polish Lavu. Well, I'm all set up now. Just got the Polish teepee up. I spent a bit of time a couple of days ago thoroughly waterproofing it. The forecast is torrential rain and heavy winds coming in approximately about 10 o'clock tonight. Quarter to seven now, so about 3 hours time we should start getting the rain, hopefully. I've brought my Zoom H2N recorder, so I'm going to try and record the sounds of the rain and the wind in the wood. It should be very interesting, and should be an eventful night. I'm hoping to relax and listen to the beautiful sounds of the storm. So let's see how it goes. I think I'll set up now and light me candle lantern, get a brew on, a few other bits and pieces. I'll get back to you. So I'll light the candle lantern up. I generally find when getting about three camps per candle, and that's using the candle fairy sparingly, they seem to last about three camps, so I get through quite a few candles in a year. Anyway, it gives off a usable amount of light, not an enormous amount, and certainly not a great deal of heat. Someone asked me how warm does it get with a candle lantern. Bit of a daft question, really. Just imagine how hot one candle is. You know, there's not an awful lot of heat coming off of it, but it's a nice addition. brought with me my 27 Trangia. I find it a very useful, compact stove with all the pots and pans, everything you need in it. So I'm going to get that going now and have a brew. Wood's all wet. I don't want to be burning wood, I don't want to be making smoke, alerting people to my presence, because this is a stealth camp. So don't be doing that. Plenty of ventilation in this teepee to allow me to burn a small stove in here with no problems. I'm sure you've seen how they all go together. Nothing to go wrong. Very, very stable cooking platform. You can light it and leave it, you haven't got to worry about it. Great little bit of kit. No problem seeing the stove in the dark. Well guys, I got some of this nice tea. It's what my friend Keith in Hawaii sent me. Thanks for this, Keith. I saved them, they're delicious. I'm using a few new items of kit. They're not actually new, they're second hand and things that were discarded by someone else. I've got them now. One of them is this thing called a thermal mug. I don't know if you can see that very well. It's kind of like a flask, but it's very effective at keeping your tea nice and warm. And you can put a lid on it, and so if it topples over, you're not going to spill anything. The kit I'm using on this camp is all cheap. The Polish teepee, £17 or £18 from Military Mart, I think, on eBay. British Army Arctic bag, a simple blow-up mattress. This is all cheap. You haven't got to spend a lot of money, and there are. Channels out there, you know, that really gone overboard. You know, they've more or less sold their souls to Snugpack. You know, you don't have to spend a lot of money to get gear to go into the outdoors and enjoy yourself. So I'm doing it on the cheap, and this is winter, and this is going to be one of the most inclement nights going. So this is going to be a thorough test of the equipment. Sorry about the picture; it seems to have gone a bit blurry. I think the camera's finding it difficult to focus in the low light. Anyway, I'll get back to you. Oh, there it goes. It suddenly decided it can see me. I'll get back to you in a minute. I think my brew's getting pretty close to boiling there. When I first got into camp, I had to fashion a few pegs of hazel using my knife. I always carry a little cleaning kit. Yeah, this is just a piece of kitchen towel with some WD-40 sprayed onto it. Just after you've used the knife, just to give it just a wipe over. Mind the edge, mind. Make sure you're going away from the edge. I'll just keep the knife in top shape. There you go. You can now be put away. It's not going to go rusty. I often get asked, why do I come out into the woods and do these sort of things and that, you know. And it's a kind of escapism, I suppose. But I think it's really to try and connect with some meaning, some deeper meaning. And you know, your mind's always active, always working. And when you come out into nature, and I've come out tonight to experience the beauty of a storm, and I'm hoping that the beauty of the storm will render my mind speechless, if that makes sense. Because when your mind has been rendered speechless, you reach a state of inner stillness, and then there's peace and beauty and all those sort of things around, you know. And it's nice to just come out into nature to experience that, and you are not going to get it sat in front of a TV screen or a computer screen in your house in the middle of some town somewhere. So it's nice to come out into nature and make that connection. Hope that makes sense. Oh well, I'm reading this electronic book called A Nook, which my family kindly bought me, my daughter actually. She calls herself Wiltshire Girl on YouTube. Thanks, Anne. I'm finding it a really interesting thing. It's so easy to read, but with my eyesight, the reading's not the best. I have to wear reading glasses, but this makes it so much easier. I don't need to wear... I don't need a torch on this. It self-illuminates. It's so easy. It's got the Nook. Anyway, it's 9:30 now. Nice and toasty warm. I got Elsa down here in a sleeping bag, keeping me really warm. And I noticed that the wind's picking up, and I can hear this deep roar in the treetops, the wind surfing the treetops. I can hear traffic in the distance. The wind's blowing the noise of the traffic to me. But there's definitely an increasing presence of wind in the treetops, and we've had a little bit of rain, but not nothing to talk about just yet. But the main rain front's due to come in the next sort of hour, I suppose. So I'll keep you updated as soon as that happens. I'll have the camera rolling, and I'll be recording the sound of nature on the Zoom H2N. I'm going to do some more reading now. The winds are beginning to start now. A few spots of rain, nothing spectacular just yet. But anyway, I'm going to hit the sack, I think. And if there's anything in the way of lots of rain and wind, I'll be sure to record it. So in the meantime, that's better. I'm going to get to bed. Good night, everybody. Well, we had very heavy rain non-stop from around about 1 o'clock in the morning to now. It's just gone 6 o'clock in the morning. The Lavu itself is extremely stable. No guy ropes, so you know, if you do go out in the night time, you haven't got to worry about tipping over guy wires. This particular Lavu was built in 1975, making it sort of nearly 40 years old. 38 years old, is it? Approximately. All I've done to it is I give it a good thorough treating of Fabsil waterproofer, and there's not been a single drop of moisture penetration, apart from over by the door. The only letdown is that you can't close the door very easily. And it's very hard to close the door using the buttons provided. So I've rigged up another method of shutting the door on this Lavu, but it doesn't quite close it completely. There's a little gap, maybe about a half an inch, and there's just been a little bit of moisture coming over there, but I mean, that's right over there, you know, so no problem at all. The armholes themselves, I'll show you those in close up in a minute. I don't know if you can see. Can you see that or not? Well, there's the a lower armhole. Let me just turn the camera so you can see it. Just show you the armhole, because I always thought when I got this ladder, I thought, "Crens, that's going to be a weak point. That's going to leak there." But they don't leak at all. Just zoom in. See it very well. No, no, you can't. There. Right, there we are. That's just a piece of thread. But there's absolutely no water ingress whatsoever on any of the armholes. They're all like that. They're all as dry as a bone. Now, this is a single skin tent. There, you can see that out there. I've had the Trangia stove brewing up in here. But it's dry. If this had been a modern nylon or plastic tent, especially a single skin tent, I'd have had all sorts of problems. But not in here. Also, the sound of the rain is different on on canvas, on proper canvas. It's a much warmer, deadened sound, if you like. It sounds a bit like that, I guess. Anyway, I thoroughly enjoyed my night in the Lavu. And I'm going to sit and doze for another couple of hours yet. Something else I've just bought as well, I'll show you this. If I come down here, this isn't a very good light for you, but there, perhaps you can see it better. This is an inflatable mattress. I bought it from Go Outdoors for the grand sum of £7.99, and it's given me the most comfortable night I've ever had. When I sleep on the ground, I've normally slept on those self-inflating mattresses, and they're about an inch and a half thick, and that I always wake up with a bad back. Well, I haven't woken up with a bad back. I've had a reasonable night. I've been quite comfortable. I've been quite warm, thanks to this £7.99 inflatable mattress, and it folds up and packs down almost nothing as well. So anyway, I'm going to get another couple of hours dozing, and then I'll get back to you. Lit the Trangia, waiting for it to bloom. Have my morning cup of tea. And I'm actually going to cook my breakfast in bed. Just gone 7 o'clock now. Clock time. There we are, look. Once it's bloomed like that, you can... Still got some strong winds and some rain outside. The other good thing with these tranches, of course, is you don't get flare-ups with them. If you have a petrol stove in a, inside a tent, definitely not a good idea. But this is no problem at all with the little tranche. Breakfast is a cooking. Some sausages and hash brown. A couple of eggs shortly. And a nice cup of tea. The sausages have been cooked and partially eaten, and the egg now is frying. And I'll tell you what, you certainly couldn't do this in a normal tent, but you can do it in a lavu, in the Polish teepee. But it doesn't pay to have the tranche burner running flat out, because it does get a lot of heat build up. But using the simmering, perfect. Well, I opened the door to a stormy scene. The wind and rain are supposed to abate by about 8 or 9, but it's still very well set in out there, so I might sit tight a bit longer. But I think I'll go out and just give you a quick look round the outside of the teepee. Welcome to the outdoors. In all its glory. So I'm all packed up inside now, just the ground sheet to pack up and then strike the teepee down. This is a wonderful little teepee. They are very, very cheap, less than £20. No guy ropes. You can put them up in 4 minutes flat. Very robust. Very stable in strong winds as well. So anyway, thanks for joining me on this winter wild camp. Hopefully there'll be many more, but you can see wind is still setting. And there's little Elsa, look.
thanks Woodland for a lovely camp, and we'll be back here again soon to watch the seasons change. I already notice there's already buds of spring, and we're not even into January yet. Look, the green buds of next year's leaves. There is no future, there is only now. I asked the oak tree, what time is it? And the oak tree said, the time is now. So now is the time to get out, to enjoy nature and all the weathers and everything it can throw at you. What an experience, that's wonderful. Thanks for joining me on this trip. I hope you've enjoyed it. See you in the next video. Plenty more to come. In the clock time future.